Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss when to initiate and how to start anti-diabetes agents, whether you are intern, PG student or general practitioner. This video will be helpful. It will be helpful for you to decide whether you should start the medicines. If you are starting the medications, whether you will start with a single agent or a double agent therapy in type 2 diabetes patients, and how to titrate the dose according to the glycemic response. Disclaimer, this is for only medical professional. It is not a prescription and there is no advertisement for any brand or company. Based on the ADA guidelines, depending on the HbA1c level, we can decide whether medicine has to be started or we can go for lifestyle modification only. So if the HbA1c is below 7, lifestyle modification is required. No anti-diabetes medicines are needed. If HbA1c is between 7 to 8.5, in that scenario, start with a single agent. If HbA1c is between 8.5 to 10, then double agent from different class of oral diabetic agents will be started. And if it is more than 10, ideally insulin should be started along with the oral agents. And for insulin, there is a separate video. You can watch that video, how to initiate insulin in type 2 diabetes patient. Starting with monotherapy, if patient comes to you with the HbA1c of 7 to 8.5, we can start with the monotherapy. But importantly, remember, it is the patient decision whether patient want to start with the medication or not. If patient says that my lifestyle is very bad, I will improve my lifestyle, maybe after a month or two, if HbA1c or glycemic control is not achieved, then patient will tell you that he can go for a monotherapy. So do consider the patient request. But if you are starting the monotherapy, then start the monotherapy with metformin. How metformin is started? Start metformin with 500 milligram dose, and with food or immediately after food, it will be prescribed because the gastric side effect will be less. And at what time of the day you should start this? You should start this it after dinner. Like most of the patient will have a high fasting levels. So if you give metformin in the dinner time, so it will control the fasting blood sugar levels. So usually we start it after dinner once a day. Then we will call the patient, say after 2 to 4 weeks, maybe after a month, we'll call the patient. And if the glycemic control is achieved, continue with the same dose. If glycemic control is not achieved, then you increase the dose. You increase it to 500 milligram twice a day. Split the dose 500 into two times, after breakfast and after dinner. Then again, after 2 to 4 weeks, if glycemic control is not achieved, then what you can do, you can further increase the dose. First, increase the nighttime dose, so make it 1000 milligrams, and morning dose, you keep it as same as 500 milligrams. So 1000 milligram will be after dinner and 500 milligram will be after breakfast. Then again, call the patient after 2 to 4 weeks, glycemic controlled not achieved, then make metformin 1000 milligram twice a day after breakfast and after dinner. So this is the sequence of how the metformin should be started and titrated according to the response. For example, even after 1000 milligram twice a day, glycemic control is not achieved, then you should go for a double therapy in that scenario. If glycemic control is achieved, continue with the same doses 1000 milligram twice daily and repeat the HbA1c after 2 to 3 months. If HbA1c is well under control, like it comes below 6.5, in that scenario, try to reduce the doses gradually. So this should be the protocol. Now, if HbA1c is 8.5 to 10, patient is coming to you for the first time, or HbA1c is not controlled with a single agent, then you will start with the double agent. Double agent will be metformin or DPP-4 inhibitors. So DPP-4 inhibitors like vildagliptin, sitagliptin, linagliptin can be used here. So if patient was already on metformin 1000 milligram twice a day, then you have to just add vildagliptin or sitagliptin in the patient treatment. And if patient is coming to you for the first time and you are starting the double agent, metformin protocol will remain the same. Start with 500 milligram once a day of metformin and 50 milligram once a day of vildagliptin or sitagliptin you can start with. Then again, call the patient after 4 weeks. If glycemic control is achieved, well and good. If sugars are still high, then you increase the dose of both the agents. Like what you do, you make metformin twice a day and vildagliptin or sitagliptin 50 milligram twice a day. Like that, you can make the treatment protocol. Vildagliptin and sitagliptin also come in a formulation of 100 milligram sustained release. So what you can also do that instead of giving 50 milligram twice a day, you can make vildagliptin 100 milligram once a day or sitagliptin 100 milligram once a day along with 500 twice daily of metformin. Like that you can give. And vildagliptin, sitagliptin, you can give with metformin, with meals or just after the meals, it can be given. These drugs also come in a combination form, in a fixed drug combination. Now, if glycemic control is still not achieved, then what you do? You make metformin 500 milligram plus 50 milligram of vildagliptin in the morning time and 1000 milligram of metformin plus 50 milligram of vildagliptin or sitagliptin at night time you can give. So increase the night time dose of metformin. Still glycemic control is not there, so make metformin 1000 milligram twice a day and vildagliptin or sitagliptin 50 milligram twice a day, or maybe sustained release 100 milligram of vildagliptin and 100 milligram of sitagliptin once a day can be given. What will be that once a day of sustained release vilda and sitagliptin? You can choose any time of the meal, maybe a breakfast time, lunch time or dinner time. So this is the sequence of up titration of double agent if you are giving DPP-4 inhibitor with metformin. Other combination which we can use is sulfonylurea like glimepiride, slightly more effective agent in controlling the glycemic levels. So start with 500 milligram once a day and glimepiride you can choose 0.5 or maybe 1 milligram once a day. Glimepiride should be given before food, like 15 to 30 minutes before food it should be given, and choose breakfast. If you are starting, choose breakfast so that if hypoglycemia event occur, that will be during the daytime. Patient can manage it very well, and always educate the patient about the hypoglycemic symptoms. Do not start in the evening or night time, because night time hypoglycemia will be a problem. 0.5 milligram we choose usually in elderly population, and 1 milligram in adult population of glimepiride we can start with. Now after 4 weeks, call the patient again. If glycemic control is not achieved, then make metformin twice a day and glimepiride depending on the glycemic response. If the blood sugar levels are still very high, so you can up titrate it to 2 milligram once a day also. Again, choose before breakfast time. Or if the blood sugar levels are not that high, they are hovering around say 180, 200 postprandial sugar levels, or fasting sugars are around or pre-meal sugars around 150, then in that case you can continue with 0.5 milligram and make metformin twice a day. So that depend on the glycemic levels of the patient. So you can take a decision on glimepiride doses accordingly. If patient glycemic control is still not achieved in 4 weeks time, for example, then what you do, you increase the dose of metformin to 500 milligram morning, 1000 milligram night time, and you can go till 3 milligram of glimepiride at that particular time, depending on the glycemic control. Or you can keep glimepiride as 0.5 milligram also. That will be individual decision. Still, sugars are not controlled. Make metformin 1000 milligram twice a day, and glimepiride you can go till 4 milligram once a day. Also, you can choose 2 milligram of glimepiride before breakfast and 2 milligram of glimepiride before dinner also, so that you can split the doses. It depends on the glycemic level during the daytime and in the fasting time. So this is how to start with the metformin along with the glimepiride. Now, if you are choosing gliclazide, gliclazide is available in a sustained release, extended release formulations. So this is a slightly milder form of sulfonyl urea, so preferred in elderly population. So metformin will be started 500 milligrams once a day, and start gliclazide sustained release 30 milligram once a day. Again, it should be in the morning time before breakfast you should give it. Depending on the glycemic levels, if it is not controlled, make metformin. So in this scenario, focus on the metformin, increase the doses of metformin twice a day. Depending on the blood sugar level, you can increase gliclazide to 60 milligram sustained release formulation as well, but give it only once a day morning time. Still the levels are high, then you make metformin 500 morning, 1000 night time, and gliclazide you can go till 90 milligram once a day dose also. And if the blood sugar levels are in a moderate range of pre-meals 150 and post-meals around 200, so you can keep gliclazide 30 milligram as well. And in the final step, you make metformin 1000 milligram twice a day and gliclazide up to 120 milligram once a day can be done. Now, if we are choosing SGLT inhibitor, so SGLT inhibitors, for example, dapagliflozin or empagliflozin, these are popularly available SGLT inhibitors. So start with the same dose of metformin. Remember, metformin protocol you must be seeing is almost similar. So start with 5 milligram once a day of dapagliflozin, though some of the physicians prefer starting with the 10 milligram as well. But you can titrate it to 10 milligrams once a day if sugar levels are not controlled after a month, and keep on increasing the dose of metformin in this fashion. And SGLT, they have a very important effect of weight loss. So if patient is obese, so my preference is I will choose metformin along with SGLT inhibitor if dual therapy indication is there. But if the patient is lean and thin, then I would prefer adding sulfonylurea rather than SGLT inhibitors. Then for empagliflozin, the titration dose we start with 10 milligram followed by 20 milligrams. Metformin remain the same. The protocol of metformin is same. While if patient is not improving with double therapy, then we will add another agent. And that agent will be if the maximum dose of metformin and DPP-4 inhibitor are already going on. We can add sulfonylurea or SGLT inhibitor or pioglitazone. Any of these agents can be used. For example, if individual is lean and thin, losing weight, I will add sulfonylurea. If patient is obese, I will add SGLT inhibitor. Or if patient has atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease or heart failure patient, so from the beginning, I will add SGLT inhibitor in that scenario. Pioglitazone, very important. If patient has non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, then pioglitazone will be a preferred agent along with the metformin, and the combination therapy with the DPP-4 or sulfonylurea. So my preference will be pioglitazone will be added if non-alcoholic fatty liver is there, insulin resistance risk is there. Or if patient has metformin with sulfonylurea, then in that scenario, I will add DPP-4 inhibitors. They are weight neutral. SGLT inhibitors cause weight loss. Pioglitazone can cause weight gain. So these will be the agents which I will choose. While if patient is on maximum dose of metformin with SGLT inhibitors, In that scenario, I will add either sulfonylurea, DPP4 inhibitor or pioglitazone. Now, irrespective of the HbA1c level or any other anti-diabetes use, whether patient is taking metformin or other agents plus minus, and HbA1c is 7, 6.5, any level of HbA1c. In that case, if patient has atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease like myocardial infarction, angina episodes, stroke, limb amputation, so in that condition, I will add SGLT inhibitor or I will start SGLT inhibitor or GLP-1 receptor agonist like liraglutide, I will add in that scenario. If patient has heart failure, then definitely I will add SGLT inhibitor. It is the first line agent. It decreases the mortality in heart failure. Patient, a case of chronic kidney disease, I will choose SGLT inhibitors. I will prefer these agent over GLP-1 receptor antagonist. If obesity is a concern, in that condition, I will add semaglutide. Now it is available in oral formulation. It is a GLP-1 receptor agonist. Earlier it was available, or indeed it is also available in injectable form, but oral formulation is also available. Though it is a costly drug, but weight loss is there with semaglutide. How to start semaglutide? 3 mg once a day for 1 month before breakfast, followed by 7 mg once daily, and if required, if weight loss is not to that extent as we were expecting, so if required, after month you can make it 14 mg once daily before breakfast. If postprandial hyperglycemia is a concern, we can add acarbose with the first bite of the meal, with breakfast, with lunch or with dinner, whichever is a particular meal which is heavy, so we will add acarbose in that condition. 25 to 50 milligram is the usual dose. Voglibose 0.2 to 0.3 milligram 1 to 3 times with each meal we can put. So if patient is checking the blood sugar levels and postprandial hyperglycemia is there, means a huge difference of more than 100 is there, so during that meal you can add these agent. Or you can use a short-acting secretagogue, that is repaglinide, just before the meal, 0.5 to 2 milligrams can be added. And importantly, in India, if cost factor is a concern, because most of the diabetes medicines are slightly costly, so we give metformin, sulfonylurea and pioglitazone. These will be our agents of choice. So these are the guidelines adapted from ADA for managing a case of type 2 diabetes with oral anti-diabetes agent. So if you have any questions, doubt, any feedback or any recommendation, you can put in the comment section.